Signify can be seen as a startup nowadays, you could say, with 130 years of history already in the lighting industry. And that required us to be standalone, but also to reinvent ourselves, as we are actually reinventing the world of lighting. I'm Mark van Bijsterveld, I'm the Chief HR Officer at Signify, formerly Philips Lighting, and we're the global market leader in the lighting industry. I've always been in HR. I've been a long time HR business partner of different international companies. Been with Orange Telecom, with Microsoft, and actually joined Royal Philips in 2006. Yeah, so Royal Philips, if you look at the history, it's actually founded late 1800s, right? 1891, if I'm correct. And actually, lighting is where it's all started, in Eindhoven, still called the Light City of the Netherlands. And actually, yeah, almost 130 years ago, lighting has been the cornerstone of Royal Philips. And of course, that company diversified. It's a healthcare business, it's the consumer lifestyle business, and it's the lighting business. But in the end, we found out there's limited overlap between these three. So it makes a lot of sense to really be standalone and focus on driving the transformation that we've seen in the lighting industry to go from conventional lighting into connected lighting and digital lighting. You actually find out while you're carving out an HR organization how important actually the continuity of all your basic processes are, right? The one thing that you don't want to miss is that pay slip after the first day or after the first month of being standalone. And making sure that all these administrators and payroll processes work well took a lot of effort. And actually in that time, I started to take more and more interest of what's happening behind the scenes actually in HR and seeing also the importance of running our basic processes, but also driving innovation through technology. And yeah, when we were becoming a standalone organization, I actually raised my hand and say, well, that HR services, shared service organization, I would love to run it. And actually that's how it started in payroll. So carving out Philips Lighting was not an easy task, right? So imagine we had around 120,000 employees worldwide in Royal Philips, and around 30,000 of those were actually carved out in Philips Lighting, together with almost 40 to 50 factories. So it's quite a huge undertaking. So we needed to make sure that we had viable organizations, not only in our main markets, but also in all of those smaller markets where we maybe have 20 or 50 employees. If you look at the creation of a new standalone HR function, it's very interesting that normally when you talk to a business organization about HR, they talk about learning, they talk about talent attraction and developing of talent. Then all of a sudden, when you talk about carve-out, you talk about much more about your administrative processes and actually your payroll processes, which are the things that you really need to get right on that first day. All the other things, they can have a bit of a glimpse, but missing your first paycheck with all your employees already in a time which is highly uncertain, that's something you cannot afford. So first days we were really looking at securing continuity in all our 74 countries. But the second opportunity that was there was to really standardize. There was still a lot of legacy and complexity that we inherited from Royal Philips that we actually really wanted to let go of. So we really needed to do that together. One of the things we've done is actually brought the both payroll teams into one room. So the way you need to visualize is that actually you will see a room full of payroll experts from Signify and from ADP, and all the walls actually paved with brown paper and everything is empty. And of course they will start to work together on describing the current processes with all the opportunities and issues, and also map out the new process that where we see actually all the improvement. And it's fantastic to see that energy of the team going around that. When I talk to managers, I often use the analogy of water, right? Streaming water, because we always expect it to be there. And it's the same with your payslip. It's almost a given, and you don't realize actually all the hard work that's happening behind the scenes in the back office organization of the payroll. At the end of February 2016, I was in the office, and actually getting into the elevator, and I saw that the CEO, Eric Rondolat, also stepped into the elevator with me. And I looked a little bit aside and said, well, it was really an exciting day yesterday, huh? And he was looking at me and he paused for a moment and actually said, what happened yesterday? And I said, well, we run our first payroll for Signify and it was seamless. And he really, well, he it took him a couple of seconds and then he started to congratulate me. He said, great job done. But it just reminded me actually, by the way, of how payroll sometimes, when you do things in excellence, there's no noise, right? So I think that the great thing of a payroll team is that there's no noise, everything runs smoothly, everybody's happy. My biggest takeaway of this whole carve-out process is actually the importance of planning, right? Planning together, and planning well and in advance. It took us 10 months to really design the whole administrative process again, and to really map out the, let's say, interplay between our Workday system and our ADP system, and finding the right order of changing things. So starting in time, doing it really with a team of experts, which is extremely important, and by seeing your partners like ADP, but also for us Workday or ServiceNow, some of the key providers, really as partners in this project. Signify as a company is really transforming. And if I zoom out 3-4 years from now, we will be much more of a digital IoT software-oriented company as a lighting company, and talk much more about lighting as a service, you probably will say, than lighting as a product. I think for us, what's next and what is important is to keep the continuity and to keep driving efficiencies in this. So that's why the lean knowledge and the lean knowledge on our side, but also on the ADP side, is important to continue to drive productivity improvements, to continue to drive, let's say, simplifications, which allow us then to maybe drive further standardization and look at new innovations like a better connection between our Workday and payroll systems.